How to place down columns inside Practicad. Once you've learned how to place down steel, placing down columns is very similar and very easy to do. We're going to go into the architectural bin and we're going to grab a wide flange shaped column that we've got here. We're going to select it and then we're going to click on the drawing once so that we can take a look at the parameters. We're going to go over to the item box, and once we've selected a column, the column tab should already be depressed for us. And here we should be able to see all the parameters that we can change on the fly for our columns. We have the depth of the column, flange width, flange thickness, web thickness, and of course the height of the column. The last two parameters we have will be the location and special instruction, which are common for most entities in the item box. So once we've selected all of the parameters, we can now choose our hold points and place it on the drawing. To choose your hold points for columns, you must first select the column from your architectural bin, and then go over to the item box, and you'll notice that the column button will be depressed, and here are the option to hold by different locations on the Z and X axes. You can see currently we're holding this column by the bottom center. Therefore, if we come over to the isometric view, you can see the crosshairs are directly on the bottom center. If we were to switch it to the top center, we'd now be holding the column by the top center. And we can do that, of course, on the Z and X axes. So if we'd like to place this down from the bottom, and we'd like to use the bottom left corner, we just switch it to bottom left. And now you can see the crosshairs are on the bottom left, and I can place this on my drawing wherever we'd like. The last option we have in the column tab in the item box is the snap to hold points. Now there's a tutorial called Placing Beams Between Columns, and I recommend looking at that to see a better tutorial on what snap to is for. However, we are going to briefly go over it in this video as well. What we're going to do is we're going to grab an architectural beam. We're going to choose a wide flange shape, and then we're going to go to place it. And currently, since we grabbed the beam, you can see the box here, the item box, is switched to the steel tab, and I'm holding this by the bottom center. But what we're going to do is focus on the column tab and switch it here. Notice that it says snap to center. What that means is that Practicad is only going to make the endpoint snap available in the center of the column. There is actually an endpoint snap at the top of the column, the center of the column, and the bottom of the column. And if we'd like to be able to cycle through these from plan view so that we place objects at the right elevation, we're going to need to use the snap to command. For example, I'm going to hit shift and right click and isolate the endpoint node. And notice now that the endpoint object snap is at the center of the column. Regardless of where I hold this beam, it's always at the center. It will be the same if we come over to the plan view. That endpoint that's lit on the left is actually the center of the column. So if we clicked right now, the bottom of our steel would snap to the center of the column, and that's not what we'd like. So if we'd like it to be at the top of the column, we'd simply take snap to, change it to the top, and now what we're going to do is we're going to shift right click again and isolate the endpoint node. And here you can see now that when we do that, we're going to get the endpoint node to light up at the top of the column. So here you can see it's lit up at the top of the column. This would mean that even if we came over here to the plan, if we clicked right here and then drew our steel beam, it would be off the top of the column. And that's exactly what we want. So by changing the snap under the column tab, we can make it so that we can isolate the endpoint and know that we're going to be at the right elevation of the column. That'll conclude the tutorials on the column tab in the item box.